Okay, here we are. This is Mr. Todd, the plumber man, May One Plumbing Company. We're out here at nighttime. I'm too damn busy to come out here during the day. Sorry about that. We're at Amberwood. We are on the southwest corner building where we had some stoppages. It's two cleanouts, a dual purpose. One's going in and one's going out. We are currently going to go back into the building to find out what caused it to stop up just a few days ago. Here we are, headed down the pipe and going into the building. There's a lot of people running a lot of water right now. We all just got home from work or something. So this would be a good test to see what's going on. We're in 5 feet. About 10 feet in, going into the building from the outside clean out, outside the fence, by the sidewalk. Uh-oh. Something already. What is this? Uh-oh. Uh-oh. What the heck do we got here? Hey, see that? See, this is why I put it on YouTube, so we could put it on the big screen and find out what we're looking at, because this little screen, if I didn't know better, not sure what it is. Gotta break it up with the camera. Now, when it clogged up, it was right in the middle of the building, so I think there's four units on the bottom, four on the top. Right in between two units in the middle of the place. So I think we stirred it up pretty good here. I don't know what this is, but this is something clogging. We're only about 20 feet in. I'm going to play with it and try to jam it through it, whatever it is. But I don't want to go. I don't want to break the camera. Delicate fiber optic stuff. So let's try it again. Is that him? Whatever that is. I don't know what that is. Get a better look at it. Damn it. Oh, we made it through it, okay? Whatever. Uh-oh. Stopped again. Not sure what that is. This is a stoppage of some sort. Let's try to jam through this one now without screwing the camera. Oop, oop. No. 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 Alright, we made it through that stoppage. Whatever that was. Don't want to be eating dinner when you see this. All right, here we go. We're going in probably 30. A lot of something coming down here. We're going to keep going 20, 30 feet in now. Right down the middle of the complex. The sewer runs right down the middle from one end to the other, east, from west to east. Drain from east to west, but we're going easterly from a west side cleanout. And now we're pretty far in here. Keep going in. I'm going to go in another 20, 30 feet all the way and see what's happening here. We're probably 40, 50 feet in. Hard to see anything with this much water, but let's stop for a minute and see. We're in a lot of water. Go downstream some more. Upstream, actually, huh? Keep pushing the camera. We're 50 feet away now. There's a bunch of washing machines are going off or something. It's a huge amount of water. We're at six different people are taking a bath right now. As you can see now, the path wherever that water was coming from. Oh, sorry, I'm trying to get comfortable here. We're going to keep going down the middle. Try as far as we can. Scope out the whole sewer. So when you... Let's see. We're pretty close to the other end of the building there. You see there's no water coming out here. I don't know if you could hear it on the microphone, but there's a ton of water still flowing, like a lot of wash machines are going off. We're probably 80, 90 feet into the building. I don't know how long this building is, but it's probably about 100. We're pretty close to the end here. As you can see, I have a little trouble trying to get it out this far. There's really nothing to see, so maybe I'll be pulling it back in a minute. But there's really no water down here and nothing happening. Okay, we're gonna pull it out slow. We're about 80, 90 feet in? There's nobody's home on the end unit, there's just no water running here. Go out a little bit more. That's a waste of time. Get back to where the problems are. Here we are. Going back. Any deformities? Cause a problem? Looks like it's a clog. Let's see what it is here. Oh, looks like this is where the water's coming. Go back in a little. All this water you hear is coming from right here. I jumped in or something. Back real slow. You find some problems where the water don't want to flow. Here is the normal level, nice and low. I'll back in a little. We can put some dips in the sewer. I'm pushing it forward. Here's where the water is coming in. Here it does go. Right here. Get a little closer shot. Pull it back real slow. Watch this later and see what I find wrong when I see it on the ditch. This is something I'm going back and forward. Pull it back real slow. I see something. Thought I saw some roots. Check it again and see. What is that? You know, it's hard to see with all the water found. Let's try this again. Something there. In a little. A little faster. Some stalactites and some stalagmites. Is that a little rift over there? maybe I could tell later when he put it to big screen or something. Right? What the heck it is. Maybe the water will stop running and we can see it better. So I'm going to come back slowly. This could be a problem here. Do you see? Water's flowing good. You go back into the sewer and we're underwater. It could be a little belly, a little low spot in the sewer that it causes happen. So I'm going back forward again. Okay, forward, back in, back in. So that's a normal water level right there. We go back, they were underwater then. Could have a little belly in the sewer. It would cause a clog constantly to happen. It's hard to tell right now with so much water running. About the first problem we saw, we're going to come back to that. Figure out what that is. We have to get inside the building to locate it. You don't want to be bothered this late at night. So we ain't going to do that now. Stop running by now. Look at that water though. People taking 1 hour showers. Okay, here we go. Let's see. What is that stoppage we found a little while? Something tied in right there. Going straight up or something. So I see this on the big screen, I'll be able to see it better. Soapy water, maybe it's the washing machine. That's the inside of your sewer. Wasn't part of the problem. Maybe you get hydro jetting with a couple 3,000 pounds of water pressure. Must be another vent right there or something. So if you hydro jet this, it would remove all this scale buildup. Plastic pipe, not like it's a cast iron pipe. ABS. Scale built up from 20, 30 years. Look at that. Maybe this is the problem we hit. This might need to be blasted. Yep, look at that buildup. I got a feeling this is where the clog was. See a small opening from the buildup. For whatever reason, maybe it's not pitched properly. But all this buildup, come along a little paper, clogged this whole sewer up from there all the way back. That's why the units ahead of this didn't have a problem. See that buildup? I would recommend jetting it and then camera it again to see what happens after. See, we're underwater here now. It could be a worse problem. So you're not going to get a very good picture until you get this thing jetted and then you'll camera inspect it. Give it a before and after jetting camera inspection. So we're going back and forward. Alright, we're back in. You see where the water level's always been, right down the middle of the pipe, which is not good. Water level shouldn't be sitting there. These gravity drain out. This looks like where it's been clogging up, right here. It's all closed up. Scale and some. This is probably where it's been clogging up, right there. So I'm coming back slowly.
And this stuff won't float up because it has to go uphill and it needs gravity. See that? This is it right here. Let me check it one more time. So this stuff will not float up the hill. This is clear here. Back and forward to show you what I think is the problem. Now forward, 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 forward. Here's the buildup of the scum because ahead of this, water cannot float uphill, so it backs up here and all accumulates on this pipe. It's all buildup. Now you're going underwater because the pipe virtually is sunken or something. And the water has to now float uphill to get out. So it all builds up right here. 100 foot, about 5-10 feet of it. Oh, look at that. Now you're out of it. So you're in it. Now you're out of it. So this is where the problem is. You could locate it, those lips or something, or race. What the heck we got going on there? What's clogging that up? Okay, this is where the stoppage occurred. And it will stop up again until something fits. Step number one, hydrojet it. A couple hours of hard work, making sure this gets blasted. Maybe we could have the camera in there while we're jetting it. Bad news though, it's not cheap. Uh-oh, so we got two problems? This rip? Uh-oh. So we already went through that problem down there. Go forward again. Go forward. Okay. This don't look too bad, you know? You don't see the... Go forward a little more. A little more. Forward. Alright. Here's one of the one stop that we just talked about. I come backwards. I mean, I'm coming towards us, towards the street where it's flowing. This don't look too bad. Okay. So you have several problems in one sewer here, it appears to be. So here... See, that pipe don't look too built up. Now we get into this. Look at this. Oh my goodness. This don't look good. So I don't know if that's a root that grew through there. I'll tell you later, but that could be a root that caused this. Let's get a little closer. See, can we adjust it? Look at the root. Reflection of the light makes it hard to see, so I'll turn the... I will dim the light a little bit and hope to see a little better. Okay, we're coming back to me again, so I just push it in. Check this out one more time. Big screen sewer vision. See what this looks like. Using a 7-inch monitor here. So you got stoppage occurring right there, I'll tell you what. This is gonna clog up again pretty soon. So let's see if I can look at that roof. Where is that puppy at? Alright, just for reference point, here we are coming back out to clean out. This is the end of the pipe.
Okay.
We're out of the sewer. We're going in the clean out. You get a reference of where we're at.
Jam it
into the sewer. Water's flowing. We're going back into the building still now. And I'm still not clearly convinced what's going on here. So we're going back in 5 feet. 10 feet, we're underwater. Okay? This ain't good. That looks good. That don't look good. Going forward. Forward. Alright, so you have a section there where it goes underwater and comes back out. I'll show you again. This is fairly normal. We're going to pull it out to me. There we go.
Okay, back in the store. Here we go. Going into the sewer upstream. One final time. This is where all the problems are. 10 feet in. Now is that a root or... We turn the lights down. And I think the reflection from the lights is half harming the video quality. Maybe somehow it has to focus or adjust, but that could be a pile of roots. We're going to measure exactly where that is. That's a separate issue from what's down here. Okay, now that's a root, okay? The sewer has been busted through by these roots. Okay, we're going to need to locate that. Of course, we'll need the people home during the day or somebody with a pass key to tell you exactly where that's located. But first, we're going to hydro jet it with a special root cutter and 2 to 3,000 PSI. Slowly going back in. Now we're underwater again. Underwater still. This is the other problem. Now that they quit running water, we'll get a better vision. So we'll do this one more time because they're not running much water. And you'll be able to see much better. The washing machines have drained or whatever. Look at the buildup. Soap scum, maybe just from the washing machine, maybe the powdered soap they're using in the washing machine. Perhaps. Gotta build up soap scum. Maybe grease and oil. Tortillas and french fries. Whatever. Bacon grease. Going back in some more. Okay, coming back out. Final time, no water running. Looking good. Looks good. I think the lens got a little schmutz on it. Now we got a blurry picture. Uh-oh. But we've seen this before. This is all the buildup. Pulling it out. I'm going to measure the first stoppage from this hole. Need some windshield wipers on this thing. Uh-oh. That damn thing stepped out. Going in. It's stuck coming out. Alright. Not much going here, Steve.
Maybe I'll quick at the cleanup going out.
Pull it back slowly. Let's say 10 feet, you got some schmutz here, buddy. Those are definitely roots. So it's not like you're just going to go in the grass and dig it out. Let's go through it. If I say this is 10 feet, go through them pile of roots. Where last time it was clogged up about 50 feet away. But this buildup on the walls is caused from them roots. Go in a little more, 10 feet, 12 feet, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. A lot of buildup right here, 20 feet or so, 3,000 pounds of water pressure, clear all that out. And I think our sewer clog, when I was here a few days ago, was right about, think of that, no water running to see you in with. Yeah. Lots of buildup. Out here is where a sewer clogged up when I was here a few days ago. There are some big trees out front. Some of them broke through. A little more. About where we had a stoppage, or maybe it's just been clogged here, but looks like the roots caused most of it. Everything harder back from here doesn't look this bad. But the roots started the problem. And then, that's all she wrote. Okay? Final passage out, 50 feet out, 40, 30. Okay, here's the first passage, I think it's 20 and 10 feet. Let's see what we got. Some stalactites and stalagmites. Thousand PSI should clear this up. Be carefully done. I'm up to the root now. Yep. Here's the side we started on right here. Something broke through the pipe. Can I tell you where it is? So there it is. There we go. Mucho problemo right here. Okay? Gotta be cleared out. Contact Todd the plumber, and A1 Plumbing Company. Now, here we are outside the sewer. We're going to find the smart cap. Now we're going to go into the clean out. It goes off to the street. Give you a quick scope of that. Never had no backups this way. Now it's going out towards the street. Here's where we go. Up to the street from the clean out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, we're making some elbows going out sideways here to the driveway maybe. No any problems here so far. There are some big trees out here by the park or the sidewalk. Big ugly trees. See if we see any roots right here. Mm. down, getting deep out here. You're not close to the city sewer now. I don't see any problems. Green plastic pipe is right by the city. Might be where it drops into the city sewer. A little farther to make sure. Uh-oh. No bueno. You know what that is? The rutabaga. Big old rutabaga. That's gonna be a big problem. Every time you flush your toilet, that root in that tree there gets a drink of water. That should be a clean out out there. It's such like a property line clean out somewhere out there. Straight up, okay? If you're coming down this white pipe, somewhere down this parkway, there might be a clean out, and that's where the roots grow through that pipe. See what happens as we go around that root. We're in clay pipe now. So once again, we need to jet this thing in both directions. It'll be a 3-hour minimum. It's going to cost you $750 to clear this entire line. We're not out to the city sewer yet. This is all clay pipe. We're way out there, very deep under the street. Looking good? Looking good. I see no problems here. Looking good. Play the pipe. Under the street. Should be going into the city sewer here. Yep, there it is. Say hello to the city of San Diego sewer system. We are now in it. Alright, I'm gonna pull it off slowly. One more time, final time. In the main sewer line, there's the city sewer running down the middle of the street. Here's your sewer. Everything looks fine here if you get to the property line clean out. You have a problem there, huh? Alright, we're coming back. Show you. There it is, what it is. Big ugly root. Coming down from a pipe above, which is obviously a clean out. I'm going to walk into a local direction. I'm going to tell you where that pump is going. There it is. If we're going to let it sit here, I'm going to get the locator. Thank you. find it. Any more myself. Trouble. I'm going to pull it back a little. I can't keep that. I'm going to go inside. I'm right with you. Got to come back another 5 or 10 feet. I'm going to draw a line. Mark it off for you. There's some elbows here. We got to figure out where it's bending. That's pretty tricky. Don't look good. It's going right underneath the middle of this, smack dab under the middle of this huge tree. That's actually three trees in one. Okay. Move that forward. For another reason. It's dropping down. Let me see this. Going straight. And then it's dropping down. There's something funky. Make sure it locates this one. I'll be right back. brought another 10 feet in a pound. They marked it off and going in a little further. Is that it?
Okay, that's what I'm trying to find, right there.
I'll be right back, don't go nowhere. I think we located it as a clean out.
That's just under the sidewalk.
Not much good. Whatever that is, under the sidewalk. Got a little further.
Right there, past the problem.
And we'll try one more time. go out one more time, a little further.
I'm all done. I don't think he's gonna give it to me, and my credit's no good, so I better.
Oh, yeah, as you say, they haven't paid me yet. I'm still waiting for that money. I work real late. I wait till they close. Waited till they closed and I went out there and did a job on it. But the batter's going dead on my rotator. That's what's keeping that there. And he pours 2 sized batteries. I'm things on Facebook. What would on Facebook you find the food with 1 mile of water on it? And exactly what it is. Diesel engines, you know, fashion drivers take the food on the street and take off the road. Now, how could I actually buy a high-fat drive with 30,000 pounds in the market? Nah, I gave up on that. I'm just going to go with the V8 5.5 liter. I don't think the guy is there. I don't know if the guy is going to be able to do it. I don't know if the guy is going to be able to do it.
Spin it out.
Oh yeah, that's what you need, but it's not too heavy and big. Yeah, but how are you gonna recharge it? How are you gonna recharge it? It's got a rechargeable battery, just plug it in. You don't have to buy batteries and shit. Yeah, just plug it in and recharge it. Some cool shit out there, man. Listen. All right, this is Todd the Plumber over and out. We're about done here. Forgot I'm recording this and I'm talking on the phone with my friend. This is all going on YouTube and I forgot I was talking to you while I'm recording this. All right, well, give me a call later, man. I'm going to finish this job up. Adios. Okay, we're winding the cable up right now. We had about 50 feet out. I've located a cleanout, and apparently, it's right next to this big, huge tree. Gigantic. You can see we got several problems in the sewer. Is that forward? Show it to him one time. The roof. A little roof. You go through the roof. And everything's okay. You see that? Pull it backwards. There's the roof. Looks like it goes into a clay pipe. And it's going to be very hard getting to it. I'm going to have to find out how deep this is. I'm going to try this one more time. Find out how deep this is. Hold on. clean out there. It's not good news. It's very, very deep. Hopefully we can find this clean out. Right there. Apparently looks like a clean out going up. We gotta find it. Could be up. 3 feet deep, could be 4 feet deep, 5 feet deep. Otherwise, we're just gonna jet from here. Okay. Not much else we can do here. Have any questions or comments to Todd the Plumber Man? He's a pretty cool dude. You can call him anytime. Don't go in too early or too late. 619-588-8500. This would conclude the tour video inspection for Amberwood Apartments. This is Mr. Todd, over and out. Good night.